coordinated fire attack study builds on all of UL FSRI's previous research.
This study focuses primarily on the sequencing of ventilation and suppression operations on the fireground to improve victim survivability and firefighter safety.
We're taking the experience from the streets and mixing it with science and true data to save civilian lives more so in the future than we ever have in the past.
We're taking the research out of the laboratory, out into the field, working with the fire service to burn acquired structures to get that additional realism.
And thanks to the assistance of DHS, FEMA, and UL, we've been able to take the laboratory to the street. We've brought our trailer and all our instrumentation out to the field.
For the first time, we're getting a cross set of environments. The single family dwelling, the multi-family dwellings, and then the commercial setting.
This is a real house with real furnishings. It's gonna rain today, and you can't get any more real than what's going on here.
The structures here are real structures. About 90 days ago is when people got moved out of here.
Without the data, this becomes just a demonstration. Adding that level of instrumentation and data really allows us to quantify the fireground versus just watching the fireground.
Using our instrumentation, we can look at things such as heat flux, pressure, and temperature. Combined together with instrumentation from the Illinois Fire Service Institute, this whole complement of instrumentation allows us to look holistically at the benefits of coordinating our suppression tactics with ventilation.
Using pigskin, we're assessing risk for skin burns. We have another laser-based system that is focused on moisture measurements. We have a new system to quantify time-resolved measurements of hydrogen cyanide, which really complements the carbon dioxide, carbon monoxide, and oxygen sensors that UL typically uses.
Very important for us to have fire service partners. Ultimately, without their partnership, we aren't able to get these structures. We can't do it on our own.
I'm hoping that the way we are doing our tactics now can change to help save more lives, because this is what it's all about. It's about saving firefighters, saving the occupants inside.